We're at harvest time. It's time to make the sauce. I'm going to make some nice tomato sauce today using the GoWise pressure cooker. Since we have a load of tomatoes here, I'm going to use the 14-quart GoWise pressure cooker for this project. This holds a lot of tomatoes. So I have a very big vessel here that I can use. And the tomatoes, I have 10 pounds of tomatoes laying here on the table. What I'm going to do is cut off the ends, where the stem is, and quarter them lengthwise. Because we're actually going to keep the skins in this recipe. The skins and the seeds stay. These are plum tomatoes, and a lot of the nutrients are in the skins. So we're actually going to keep them in the sauce. The other things that we're going to use, as we put this together, some salt and pepper, some celery, some sweet onions, parsley, fresh garlic, some peppers. I have the red sweet peppers, and I have some poblanos to add a little bit of zip. I'm going to start the pot with some butter, and we have oregano, we have basil, and we have crushed red pepper. At the very end, when we're starting to make this sauce nice and thick, I'm going to add the Parmesan Romano cheese and some tomato paste to get the right consistency. So to get started here, I'm going to plug in the GoWise pressure cooker on a simmering mode, and then I'm going to add the garlic, the celery, the onions, and start to get the flavors going into some butter. I plugged in the pressure cooker, and I'm going to press the saute button. That's what we're going to use to brown the celery and the onions and garlic. You can see that it went to 30 minutes. So as that's warming up, I'm going to add a half a stick of butter. And I'm going to start chopping up the onion, celery, and garlic. All right, the butter's nice and melted now. And I'm just going to throw in handfuls of celery and onions. I'm going to brown them nicely. You can see I sliced the celery very thin because I don't want it to be big chunks in the sauce. There you go. And then I'm going to add some garlic, which I have rough chopped garlic, and I have some very fine garlic. Mix all that in. I'm going to keep this on simmer until it starts to become translucent. In the meantime, I'm going to cut up the tomatoes and the peppers. Can you see how the butter is starting to brown the vegetables that are already in there? The smell is overwhelmingly good. Now I have a cutting board full of red peppers chopped and the poblanos. And we're going to add those in and let them start to saute as well. Wow. Is that a nice start to a nice bowl of sauce? Alright, back to the tomatoes. Now, I'm not going to put you through the pain of watching me cut all these tomatoes, but I just want to show you what I'm going to do. Nice, meaty plum tomatoes. That's why we're choosing these. Cut off the end, and then I'm cutting it in quarters this way. So you can see that I'm going to get some seeds, but this is the reason we use the plum tomatoes, and the flavor is good as well. There's not a lot of juice and seeds that will come out of the tomato, but it makes a nice thick sauce. So this is how we're going to throw them in. I'm just going to cut up this whole pile, and then we're going to add them to the pot. Okay, take a look inside the pot here. I want to show you how beautiful this looks. Look at that. These onions are exactly where we want them to be right now. And the peppers are giving off flavors and juices, getting all ready for their doing their job here. Look at the celery. It's perfect. Perfect. Okay, what I'm going to do now is take about half the tomatoes that I've quartered. You see this pot? And the reason I'm pouring these in before I get the rest finished is I want them to start giving off juices. You hear them hitting that sizzle there? The reason I want them to start with giving off juices is when I get all the tomatoes in, they're gonna we're gonna put the lid on and we're gonna bring it up to pressure. And I don't wanna add a lot of extra water to make this come up to pressure. I'm gonna use the juice of the tomatoes that we already have. That'll make the sauce thicker and richer. And we won't have to cook off the water so much at the end. All right, so we're gonna let them start breaking down and I'm gonna cut the rest and we'll put the whole pot together. Now take a look in here. Look at all the liquids coming off the tomato. And it's starting to soften. That's what we're gonna use to start the pressure of this pot. Now let's add the spices. We have oregano. We have basil. We have some crushed red pepper. There's some regular black pepper ground. And here's where you add salt, if you love to add salt. I'm gonna add just a little. Not my thing, but people like to add salt. Here's some fresh parsley chopped up. And then we're gonna add the rest of the tomatoes at this point that have been quartered up. There's some. There's some more. And you can see why I used the big Go Wise 14 quarts of goodness here. Let's just turn everything in a little bit. We're gonna let a little bit more juices come off of these tomatoes. And now we're gonna cap it up and cook it under pressure. I'll give it 5 more minutes and then we'll start it up. All right, now take a look in here. We have a lot of liquids here. There's nothing to worry about adding any water or anything to this. And the tomatoes are starting to break down, so let's put the lid on. Lock it into place. And we're gonna set this manually here. First, pick our own pressure time. We're gonna make this 20 minutes. All right, it'll come up to pressure and it'll start cooking. We're gonna make sure that this is set in the pressure mode on the valve. And we'll be back to let the pressure out in 20 minutes. Well, the cooking has ended. I'm gonna release the pressure here. You can watch. On the front, it'll show you how much pressure's left in there on the way out. You can see how quickly it goes, and we'll soon be able to open the pot. I can smell a lot of delicious sauce right now. You can see we're down to about 4 pounds of pressure. Usually, if it gets into the 3.5 or 8, I can open the pot. Okay, we're at 3.8. The pin dropped for pressure, and we're going to open it up. Wow. Take a look. Now, everything is intact as we left it in here, but everything is very well cooked. And it smells delicious. And what we're going to do now is use the immersion blender and introduce some of the tomato paste. This will help thicken it up. And we're going to add the Romano Parmesan cheese at this point too. Now in the meantime, I'm going to start some spaghetti cooking on the stove. All right, let me get the blender out and then I'll show you how that works. I'm gonna add the Parmesan Romano cheese here, about 1/2 cup or so. And then I'm going to use my iCook immersion blender, and this has a series of blades on the bottom, and we just immerse it into the sauce and blend it. Keep plunging in here, and I know it's hard to hear me when I'm running it. I'm just going to keep plunging in until it's nice and smooth. So I'm going to keep going here a little bit. You do this depends on how much you want it to be smooth. If you like a little bit of chunks in there, a little bit of tomatoes and spices, I kind of like it like this because it shows some of the vegetables that we used, but yet it's a nice smooth sauce. So to me this looks perfect. Now we have made quite a large batch here today. I'm going to put some of this in the containers and freeze it, but then I'm also starting some spaghetti on the stove so that we can eat it for supper tonight. So I'm using the Copper Chef pan over here. I don't know if you can see it from there. It's a nice square pan and the spaghetti fits right in there. So you don't have to worry about breaking up your spaghetti. And Rick and I are gonna have a nice spaghetti dinner tonight. So it's only a few minutes away and I'll show you what that looks like and we'll taste it. Okay, so see how easy it is? You don't have to make sauce for cooking all day, all weekend, overnight, and all that. It takes 20 minutes of cooking time in your pressure cooker, and this GoWise is such a nice big size that you can do a large quantity all at one time. So I hope you get to try this. I'll show you how it looks in spaghetti in a few minutes. Okay, it's supper time. Let's make some nice plates of spaghetti here. Hungry?
Yeah.
I knew it. Come up close, I'll show you the sauce. It's coming. Would you like a little cheese on yours?
Yeah. Is that mine?
This is yours.
Thank you. Ooh.
Does it taste like we were cooking it all day?
Yeah. It's hot.
Take your time there. Okay, here's our supper. Nice fresh sauce. Hope you like this video and hope you get a chance to try making some in your pressure cooker too, because it's so quick and delicious. Thanks for watching.